There is, perhaps, no book more often quoted than the Holy Bible. No other book has been more widely read or translated into more languages. Nor has any other book survived the test of time with such power and relevance. The pages of the Bible reveal glimpses of our own humanity and the divine through timeless stories of men and women who have been touched by God. Stories of hope. Stories of devotion. Stories of the struggle between good and evil. Stories of the life and teachings of Jesus Christ, as well as stories of lives that have been transformed. For centuries, the Bible has been a source of great inspiration. But the Bible is so much more. For those of faith, it is the living Word of God, given to all people. It is permeated with the breath of God, and made alive in the hearts and minds of God's people. The Bible is the most important guiding document in our lives. But how much do we really know about what the Bible reveals?
He was just like speaking to me, just like, here I am. If you want to talk to me, I'm going to speak to you through my word. And it was so powerful.
To know God, to follow Christ, and to grow in spiritual maturity, we must know the Bible. To incorporate the stories of the Bible into our lives, we must make Bible study a regular part of our journey. The Bible is a collection of 66 books, works of history, law, poetry, and prophecy, written by a variety of authors spanning thousands of years. First recounted in an oral tradition, the stories of the Bible were later gathered and written down. Though the product of human hands, we believe the authors of the Bible were inspired by God, their words reflecting the way God spoke to them in their day. The Bible is divided into two parts, or testaments. The first, the Hebrew Scriptures, is called the Old Testament. It tells us of God's interaction with His children. The Christian Testament, commonly called the New Testament, records the life and teachings of Jesus Christ and describes how the early church was formed. The Apocrypha is found in between the Old and New Testaments. The Apocrypha serves as a bridge between the two and helps make events in the New Testament more clear historically. Today, the Bible is the most widely reproduced book in history. Regular Bible study is important to our spiritual growth. The Bible is the story of how the people of God understood and responded to God in their lives. We experience the Bible even today by hearing the Scriptures in the context of our own time and our own place in history. The Bible doesn't tell us what to do. It tells us who we are as children of God. By studying the stories of others who have gone before us, we can make better, more informed responses to the situations we face today.
It keeps my family grounded, and it's important to my family because it keeps us at peace.
The Bible is our family story, one with which we retell and celebrate what God has done for us. The story of the people of God doesn't end with the last book of the Bible. It continues as we continue living lives of faith. Like the stories within the Scriptures, our stories are sacred too. Studying the Bible can provide inspiration, but more importantly, studying puts events and lessons into perspective and allows us to better understand what the Scriptures mean today. Fortunately, we are not on our own. There are many tools available to help us understand the Bible. Study Bibles, for example, are an excellent resource. Along with the text of Scripture, the Study Bible also includes annotations, footnotes, definitions and explanations of word usage. Another useful tool is a concordance, which cross-references words and phrases with specific passages in the Bible. For instance, you can look up water and find hundreds of references in Scripture. A Bible handbook supplements your reading with references, explanations, and additional ideas. Many other study materials are also available, including Bible dictionaries and atlases, as well as any number of Bibles translated into modern English. Some use very traditional language, and others are more contemporary. With all of these tools available, it is now easier to develop a deeper and better understanding of God's Word than ever before. But the most important step is to develop a plan for regular Bible study. Set aside specific times during the week just for study. Choose a book of the Bible or follow the lectionary found in the back of the Book of Common Prayer. Keep notes while you study. Write down story points as you go along, and any questions or ideas that come to mind. If possible, join a Bible study group at church. By interacting with others, you can share ideas, ask questions, and provide support and motivation.
There was a man who came to our Bible study, the very beginning Bible study that we had, and he brought with him a cardboard box full of 3 concordances, 4 or 5 Bibles, and a number of other books describing what was in the scriptures. Over the years, he's moved from beyond just what's in the book to living the life that's described in the book.
When you're reading the Bible, you are in the presence of God, even if you don't know that.
The Bible is often called a living document because its lessons are as relevant today as they were when they were first written. Regular Bible study prepares us to live our lives as disciples. We get a clearer understanding of God's Word and of the teachings of Jesus Christ. We've seen how prayer and Bible study are important to developing our spiritual maturity. We also have to put our faith into action with our time, talents, and treasure. And we'll learn how to do that next as the Discovery Series, A Christian Journey, continues.